Wow! Definitely different stabilities. I think... Welcome back to another day of Vlogmas. Today we are going to be doing a challenge between the Prototype MD5 and the Cryostone Flex 1 C-Line MD5. 9 holes here at Williams Park. Scary dogs in the background, but let's get into it. Alrighty, first I'm going to tell you the main differences between the Prototype C-Line MD5 and the Cryostone Flex 1 C-Line MD5. So the Flex 1 plastic, it's different from regular C-Line because the Flex 1 meaning it's more pliable, more flexible. This is more your standard C-Line MD5, stiff. Love the feeling of this, but for colder weather, this might be your better option. But we're gonna test them both out here. It's around 45 degrees Fahrenheit here. Right here, we're gonna put Celsius. Anyway, hole one, probably 180 feet. I'm really curious to see the ground play that the Flex 1 C-Line MD5 has versus the Prototype Metal Flick MD5. Alrighty, fresh out the car shots. I think we're just gonna go standard backhands, both hyzers. Try to see if there's any difference in flight, which I don't think there will be, but Prototype MD5 first. Hey, that's underneath it. Now, the Cryo MD5. Little ground play, not bad. Once we get into C1 with our drives or our upshots, we can putt with our regular putters. But anything outside circle one, we're still gonna use the MD5. So my first impressions of the Flex 1 MD5 is that it is super grippy. If you have a problem with the regular C-Line being kind of slick, I think this would be a good choice for you. It's not quite as grippy as C-Line, but it's kind of gummy and tacky too. Oh. I'm gonna blame it for being the first putt of the day. No excuses though. Solo lead right now, one under. Hole two, Metal Flake MD5 has a box. Gonna go backhand turnover, hammer on Anheuser and see how it fights out of it. I didn't quite get over enough on it. Ooh, that might be circle two. I'm gonna try to get more over on this Flex 1 MD5. Oh yeah, mucho better. So I'm really curious to see how the Cryostone compares to the new S-Line MD5, because that's gonna be the next drop by Discmania. Supposedly we're getting them, I hope we do. That way we can continue to make content for you guys. But the MD5s are one of my favorite molds so far from Discmania. I do think, for me, what I would like personally is like a baseline MD5. I think that would be a sweet utility disc. But here we are, rolling up on my Metal Flake MD5. No! Sit. Okay, that's circle one. Metal Flake MD5. Cryostone to tie it up. Both MD5s at one under. Cryostone has a box. Gonna go stand still, sidearm. Ooh. Oh no. Metal Flake MD5. Alrighty, that's a circle one putt and a circle five approach. One thing that I do really like about the Flex 1 plastic is the tackiness and the grippiness of the MD5. It is next to none. I've heard a lot of people comparing it to K1 plastic. I've never felt K1 plastic, but maybe it's similar, I don't know. But here it is. I'll show you how tacky this bad boy is. Like this. I don't know. Like you can really dig in deep to it, get a solid grip. You can really pinch down on it. I really like this disc. Perfect. Hardly any ground play. Works good. I'm cold. I'm a fair weather golfer. No! That was unfortunate. Both discs are at one under. Still a Crosstones box because MD5 player can't putt. Gonna go walk up sidearm this time. Kinda got a headwind, 5 miles an hour max. That hit the tree and it just kinda just boop boop. Huh, middle flake. Woo! Anything, I'm on circle's edge, but we'll count it as inside seat one. Caleb, you've been a half inch short your whole life. Ha! Ha! Woo! Alrighty, Crosstones only one down. Prototype MD5's two down. Proto MD5's box. Gonna go hyzer at it. Thing is beef. Sit. Doug. Pro MD5's turn. So based off of that throw, I think the Cryo MD5 might have a little bit more forgiveness to it, meaning it has a little extra glide and pop up, because I felt like I threw those pretty similar, and the Cryo MD5 wanted to drift from right to left a little bit more than the prototype MD5 did. Well, that's good to know. We'll confirm it later. We're just outside C1 with the Cryo MD5. Oh, why, Caleb? This is so sad. I just want to get a height. 3 under to 1 under. Now looking good for the Flex One MD5. So we're to the hole that was taken out. So we're gonna create a little bonus hole here. We're about 310 feet away from the pin over there in that grove. See if I can zoom in on it. It is, where am I going? Like right there. There it is. Gonna be throwing these hard and flat to give you a true flight of how these fly. Prototype MD5 has 2 strokes on the Flex One MD5. Woo! I had some hot ground play on it. I don't think this will bite as hard, and I don't think it'll have quite the ground play that the Metal Flake C-Line MD5 had. No. Wow. Definitely different stabilities. I think the Metal Flake MB5 is way, not super more overstable, but it is definitely more overstable than the Flex One MB5. But I kind of like that. That kind of flew like a really overstable MB4. I might bag both, we'll see. The difference between that this Metal Flake MD5 and that is that Flex One MD5 didn't finish near as hard as this. That dog didn't razz me, I promise. It was after the release. I'm not gonna blame nothing on a cute chocolate nib. Oh, Crosstone comeback. Did y'all see that? It's a tie ball game. We're both at 2 under. We have got a ball game on our hands. Or I guess you could say frisbee game, but that sounds weird. Disc golf game? Just ignore those thoughts. Hole 7. Tie ball game again. Both at 2 under. Crosstones box first. They got a birdie on the last hole and bogeyed with the MD5. That's pretty brutal spit out, I thought. It was right side and it just cut through. But whatever. Gonna go sidearm. See one, and then Metal Flake MD5. both in C1. I'm very surprised at the flight characteristics of the Flex 1 MD5. Personally, I thought it would be more overstable, but it's not. But I do like the ground play on it. And for on that forehand, it was a little bit wobbly, and I think that kind of hurt the distance on it. I think if it would have been more smooth at the hand, it would have got more distance, but hindsight's 20/20. Both got 20 footers. What? Metal Flake, back up one on the Cryostone. Two holes ago. Cryostone has lost its box. Metal Flake MD5. MD5, gonna go. Do a little finesse shot. Put a little, maybe put it flat, little Annie, let it drift. Come back toward the basket. Basket is about 20 feet from that left tree. Oh, yikes. So that's what you call fluffing a shot. That was not committed and that was gross. Can we make the correction? Oh my goodness. This has been a lot more entertaining from my side of things than I thought it would. Cause I thought the prototype would just obliterate the Cryostone. Obviously it has not. So we'll see if the Cryostone can get one more stroke, probably just inside the circle, but the fluffed shot with the prototype MD5, that was gross. Had a right to left win and I didn't get it over. User error, it happens, but you know what? We got one more hole after this. See who the winner is. Metal Flake MD5. Oh, I fluffed it, but that's okay. That's easily makeable. Alrighty, little tough tester for the Cryostone to pick up one stroke and to tie it up. Crispy. Fun story, I was the first person to introduce Simon to Dr. Pepper. Do you want to know what he said? He goes, ugh, that tastes like crap, that tastes like raisins. And I will never forget that because it's got 23 different flavors and it is my favorite. Shout out to Dr. Pepper, but not shout out to me for not for missing those putts. Ugh. Man, I kind of got weird there for a second. Four again. We got one hole left. Rarely will you ever see me do that, ever, unless I'm just having a really bad day. But to be honest, I love disc golf. This is kind of my me time, and I usually play disc golf by myself. If I'm like stressed or anything, you'll find me on the disc golf course, usually by myself. But I also love playing disc golf with other people, and that's part of the reason why I love playing disc golf, is because I get to meet new people from everywhere. I've got friends in different states, different countries, and yeah, here we are. Famous hole one. There we go. Alrighty. Last hole, Metal Flake MD5 has one on the Cryostone. So, Metal Flake's box. Right to left win. Gonna go back in. Mando is not in play. Wow, that might seal the deal. Cryostone. Oh, yeah, that one has more glide and push to it. That prototype MD5 has more bite when it slows down at the end of the flight. So if you're wondering what the main characteristic between that differentiates those molds in different plastics flights, it's that right there. Cryostone. Still overstable, still plenty of beef, but doesn't have quite the hookup at the end of its flight when it slows down. So the flight numbers on the MD5 are like 5204, 5104, I can't remember, maybe 5304. I would say everything's the same except the last number. I think you put it at a 3 or 3.5. Still plenty of beef, still really overstable. feels really good in the hand. And those who are in like northern parts of states or in Finland, when it's cold, I think the Flex One plastic is going to be a hot commodity. I think it's going to be a hot seller. I think it's going to be great, and I think it's great for the Discmania lineup. What plastic would you like to see in this Flex One plastic? Me personally, I think a Flex One P3X would be nasty. Just a little approach disc. All right, in circle two. Never had a chance to seal the deal. There it is. The prototype MD5 ended up beating the Flex One C-Line MD5 by 2 strokes. But the main difference between these two discs is I think the prototype MD5 being in the regular C-Line stock metal flake plastic has a little bit more bite at the end of the flight than the than its counterpart of the Flex One C-Line plastic. For colder weather, I'm probably gonna bag this. I didn't throw it well today, but I'm a fair weather golfer. So, and I'm also been used to throwing this since they came out with it probably June, July. It's July 20th, 2023. So I got it about a week before that. So I'm just accustomed to throwing this. Both mold, I mean, they're both the same mold, but I think they're both useful. Definitely this for colder weather, this for when it's warmer outside. I'm very curious to see how this flies in warmer weather. I think this will get super soft, and maybe it'll have like a roll in my bag for like touch shots to greens that are slick and it needs to grab the ground and stick near the basket. But overall, really enjoyed throwing both discs. It's a beautiful day out. Thank you guys for watching. Like, subscribe, stay reliant.